not dead. Okay. Something that will put leap. Ew, leap. Works. Okay, I can work with this now. Dead, but I can work with it. No, I'm going to hold off on that. Pobrim. We're using a Vicente instead, who can survive that. Take the hit on Hobrim. Pain, but I can work with it. We will take the shot on Dente, who will still be up. Oh, I did do that already. Never mind. I thought the other night I did that. Never mind. Also, you just did a dark wait. Oh no, I don't move forward. Okay. There we go. So if I do it like I do it there, I get the right value out of the table. Okay. Ah, so that's where I got confused about him getting an action. Actually, what if you use the Blessing Stone now? Not getting action until later. If you're still gonna zap hop him, take him down. But it reduces the number of dead characters I have to deal with. No, it doesn't reduce the number of dead characters. Oh, wait. Ah, I see how this works. Okay. Here's how we do it. Use the Blessing Stone on him. Mending Seed on that Maverick. Give him enough of a boost to stand a few hits right away. Next turn. I. Brim. I'm going to move over here where I can do something useful in combat next turn. I can't do anything useful to help heal it, the healing cycle here, but I can finish healing up Jeremy above 100. Jeremy. Ending Seed on Hoprim. Moves out of direct melee range. Chuba, let's do this. I'm gonna take advantage of the fact that guy's got that one of their own guys got clobbered with a debuff, and I'm gonna do that. Undead with the Balder Bowl, who happened to be so stupid as getting range. Five of them is fine, but honestly, I want to get you full health.
Thank you very much for watching. If you enjoyed the show, please like and subscribe. Also consider backing my Patreon. Patreon backers get episodes up to 1 week early of this show and any future Let's Plays. Also, please consider backing my Ko-fi. Toss me a few bucks, also helps support the show, and it's not a monthly obligation or anything like that.